for the current action show than you do for Total Bellas, because you're bound to see more negative reviews for this show. But the Total Bellas show does not have a reason why it can't be at least number two or three on the list of top reality shows that ER producing and marketing, because there's no reason why that can't happen. I think there is definitely a lot of things that can happen from this show in the way of positive reviews. There are a lot of things that people could say about the show in the way of negative reviews, but there are more things that people can say in the way of positive reviews, and that's one thing I'm going to be looking for and keeping my eye on the internet, because I know I love, one thing you should know about me is I love to read these blogs that people write all the time about these reality shows and these stars. These entertainment news programs seem to not get enough of these reality stars and talking very negative about them, and that's one thing that I am not going to do about the Bella Twins, because I am a really big fan of the Bella Twins. I have been very honest about my opinion when it comes to the Bella Twins. I have said more positive things about the Bella Twins than I have negative. I have not always agreed with a lot of the decisions the Bella Twins made, like their first firing. I thought their careers with professional wrestling were pretty much over, and just weeks after their first firing from WWE, they were back on television under their real name. So they obviously wanted to have something to do with the wrestling industry or television in some capacity. WWE signed them back to become reality stars, and their prediction of them becoming reality stars was followed through with, and what they wanted to do with the Bella Twins turned out to be very successful, and probably far more successful than what WWE had initially predicted that was going to be. I thought when I first saw the Bella Twins years ago, they were extremely talented, very unpredictable, and very fun to watch. And I thought that years from now, we were going to be taking the Bella Twins far more seriously than what we ever had. And obviously, people are taking the Bella Twins far more seriously, with Nikki Bella's rehabilitation from her neck surgery coming back looking better than ever, and obviously a direct competitor for that SmackDown Women's Championship, and even the Raw Women's Championship, depending on how her career goes from here on out. People are taking her far more seriously, and she seems to be more focused on what she's doing more so than what she was prior to her injury, because pretty much after having that title for months and months and months and establishing herself as the longest reigning Divas champion in what was history and making history, I think that she just wanted to get out of the spotlight for a while, and obviously losing it to Charlotte allowed her to do that. Now that she's back in the spotlight, I think the Bella Twins have never looked better, and I'm expecting to see a reunion of that tag team as they continue to promote this series. And that would be a very effective way of promoting the series, putting the Bella Twins back together as a tag team in the women's division for either Raw or SmackDown. And obviously it would probably happen for SmackDown ever before it did for Raw, because I don't think Brie Bella was strapped to either show, so she's pretty much a free agent for either brand, so she might show up on SmackDown, and we may see a reunion of this team. So I'm looking forward to seeing the most done with the Bella Twins as they try to promote this reality show. I'm hoping it doesn't take away from the promotion of Total Divas, and it receives an equal amount of promotion, and the promotion is pretty much divided down the middle, and a line is drawn emphatically between the two reality shows, because they have to be kept separate, because obviously having two reality shows is a challenge. But they want to achieve the most out of both reality shows, so they try to create one or two new reality stars or other than the Bella Twins from Total Divas and continue the success for the Bella Twins off the red carpet and all the success they've seen in the entertainment industry, along with John Cena and others who have gone that route with their careers, that they try to continue promoting the Bella Twins and have the same amount of success, even more, if not, from the premiere of Total Divas years ago, and how Total Divas really took off as a reality show that did wonders for WWE, because more people tuned into that show than they ever admitted to or gave credit for themselves for having done. I mean, the reviews Total Divas was getting in the past was definitely huge, were definitely big, and it was because of what the Bella Twins were doing for that series. So definitely you have to give a huge shout out and a huge thumbs up to them for doing what they did for the reality show. They tried bringing in people like Summer Rae, they tried bringing in Natalya, trying to make her a huge reality star. They did the same thing with the Funkadactyls. Nothing was done there. So if there ever was a driving force behind Total Divas' success in the past, and obviously had everything to do with the Bella Twins, and their popularity now, if you have not noticed, has really taken off. It has really blown up. And there is a reason to believe in the Bella Twins, and it's because they are very competent, they know what they're doing, and they are very creative and very unpredictable and just so fun to watch. I think one of the biggest things for me is just how fun they are to watch. And one thing that I've always talked about on interviews that I've done over the years with different radio shows on sites like blogtalkradio.com is how proud, emphatically proud, I have been of the Bella Twins. I don't deny being proud of the Bella Twins. I don't lie about anything about the Bella Twins, and if I don't agree with what they're doing with the Bella Twins, I don't shy away from sharing my opinion with the people who are interviewing me on radio shows or with interviews that I've conducted with many people over the years. And believe me, I've interviewed hundreds of people. I've gotten opinions on reality shows, and it doesn't seem like anyone has anything negative to say about a reality show like Total Divas or will say about Total Bellas, and that gives me 100% confidence for a very promising future that we are going to be seeing with this reality show. There is the graphic on my YouTube channel I have put together for you. You can comment on this video blog and give me your thoughts and your insight on the direction of a show like Total Bellas. I would love to know what that opinion is. You can also tweet me something at JonathanClark1 and on Google+, at HEW Entertainment, and on Facebook as well, facebook.com at HEW Entertainment. Let me know what your thoughts are on Total Bellas and what direction you see this show headed in. I predict we're going to be seeing a lot of high reviews and a lot of great things being said about it. It wouldn't surprise me if we heard a lot of negative reviews of this series. That's one thing to be expected. But until Brie or Nikki Bella are held at gunpoint, I don't think this series is going to receive as high reviews as what the Kardashians show in their new season premiering this October, October 23rd, just a few weeks after Total Bellas will drop on the E! Network. Until they are held at gunpoint, they are not going to be receiving as high of reviews, and that is one thing to be expected, because the Kardashian show, because of the name and being very established in the entertainment business for having done this or that in the past, and just how they are names that are known, everyone knows who the Kardashians are everywhere they go. And one thing that's noted in the Kardashian season premiere on October 23rd is the fact that they would love to go somewhere without anyone knowing who they are, and that's never going to happen for the Kardashians. So because they are very established and more established than the Bella Twins, and it's going to take a few years for the Bella Twins to become even more established than what they currently are right now, with the Kardashians having a slight advantage, obviously this series will receive higher reviews, and other shows will receive higher reviews, but probably not as high reviews as what we're going to be hearing about the Bella Twins reality show, Total Bellas. And we're going to see new episodes premiering weekly, at least up until the midpoint of November. So that's going to be really exciting to see where we go from here. And Daniel Bryan and John Cena have also been promoting the hell of this, with Daniel Bryan in his role as a SmackDown general manager. The good thing about Daniel Bryan being on this reality show is that Daniel Bryan has been given something to do, and that's something to be highlighted, because Daniel Bryan was looking for something to do with WWE while being the SmackDown general manager and the host of Talking Smack on the network following SmackDown every week. Was something for him to do. At least now he can focus on something else rather than wrestling week in and week out and threatening his life by threatening an injury to himself. At least now he can continue to slow it down as a reality star, because the pressure is not as high on his shoulders as what it was when he was wrestling week in and week out. So at least it will give him something to do. And apparently we are going to be seeing a lot of Daniel Bryan, and apparently we're going to be seeing more of Daniel Bryan than we are John Cena on this show. And keep in mind too, it's going to be interesting to see, even though we're not going to be seeing as much of John Cena on the show, because he has his own show on Fox. The thing is, John Cena has never been on a reality show before, so this is going to be very different, seeing John Cena making that transition from being a wrestler after having been a movie star into being a reality star, because he's never been a reality star and been on a reality show as much as what he's going to be on Total Bellas, although Daniel Bryan's appearances on this show will outnumber significantly the number of times John Cena will be featured on this series, because I'm expecting the focus, obviously, to be on the Bella Twins, and that's where it should be, as WWE tries to create one or two new reality stars off the success of this new season of Total Divas, which is not going anywhere anytime soon. If you thought it was over for reality television for WWE, we are far from the end of reality television for WWE, because we are just witnessing the beginning, and a lot of promising things will happen in the future for WWE when it comes to reality television. This will definitely be a make-or-break series for WWE, and it will determine whether or not we'll see them continue to create and promote reality television. We'll see where we go from here, and I could be more excited about it. So off that, I'm going to leave it with that thought with you. And you can get in on the conversation and tell me what you think of Total Bellas premiering this Tuesday, October the 11th, in the U.S. and Canada on the E! Network. I'm expecting this to be a huge move, a really big move for the E! Network to make, and it's probably going to be one of their most successful reality shows that we have seen in a really long time. It may not be the Kardashian show, but it is the next best thing, and a lot of great things are going to be happening because of the premiere of this happening on Tuesday night. You can get in on the conversation in the comments of my video blog on my YouTube channel at JonathanClark22, on a tweet on Twitter at JonathanClark1, on my Facebook page at HEW Entertainment, on Google+, you can join the conversation as well. Until next week, I'm your host, Jonathan Clark, and I will talk to you again really soon.
Like what you hear? Tell us on Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube.
I never met you, but I know you're out there. If I cross the oceans, would you be there?
A stranger's eyes that somehow look familiar. I know that when it's you, I'll remember. Remember, so wait for me. I swear I'll find you, climbing every wall that hides you. I know we were meant for something better. So wait for me. The world is changing. Underneath, the ground is shaking.
Share.